This has been a sacred tax-free cash cow for more than a century in the Internal Revenue Code. In this episode, I'm going to address how to legally avoid paying tax. Get ready, it's probably not what you think. So my name's Doug Andrew, and I've been a financial strategist and a retirement planning specialist for more than 47 years. And so during that time period, people have come to me through the financial dimension or portal to be able to optimize their financial assets, get the best rate of return, increase liquidity and safety, and they prefer to have tax advantages on their money if they can. So through the years, I began to help people maximize liquidity, safety, predictable rates of return, and I prefer tax-free. And I began to realize that spells an acronym, LASER, Liquid Assets, Safely Earning Return, spells the acronym LASER. So my most recent best-selling book is called The LASER Fund, and I'm going to show you how to get a free copy of that 300-page book at the end of this episode. But let me share with you how to legally avoid paying taxes, because I've helped, frankly, hundreds of thousands of people avoid paying unnecessary tax on their savings for retirement and all throughout their retirement until they pass away, even if they live to be 120 years old. You ready to learn this? So I began clear back in 1974. Yeah, I'm 69 years old, and back in 1974, I got my Series 1 securities license that allowed me to sell any stock, bond, mutual fund. I got my insurance license. I sold people term insurance in case they happened to die in an accident prematurely so that their family could continue to live the lifestyle that the breadwinner hoped to provide for them had they stayed around. And so life insurance was a good benefit, but I basically sold them term insurance and told them to invest the difference. So I would put them in a portfolio of mutual funds. And I've often said, you know, it was like playing red light, green light when you were a kid. Some periods, you would take 10, 15, 20 steps forward. You make 20% returns, but then the next period, the next year, the market would dive down and you'd have to take 10, 15 steps back, up and back, up and back. Hopefully, you are progressing on the average. But E.F. Hutton, who was a brokerage firm back then, my brother-in-law was a manager of one of their offices. E.F. Hutton is the brainchild behind the emergence of universal life. And this is what happened in 1980. They realized that even if they could earn their clients an average of 12%, okay, where you go up and back and up and back, 12% before tax is not that great, especially if inflation is greater than that. And back in the 1970s and 80s, inflation was double digit. You were earning 12%, let's say on $1 million nest egg, that's $120,000. You pull that out to live on and you have to pay between federal and state income tax, a third of that in tax. So that's $40,000. You pull out $120,000, you give $40,000 of it to the government because that's the bargain on an IRA or 401k. They're ready. It's their payday. They've been counting on that tax revenue. Uncle Sam has been your partner all along, and maybe you didn't know that. So you had to earn 12 to net 8, but many asset managers, they charge at least 1% asset management fee. So you subtract another 1% for the fee, you're earning 12 to net 7. You're only really able to use $70,000 of the $120,000 to buy gas, groceries, prescriptions, golf green fees, and so forth. And so Hutton said, what are we doing here? Yeah, we're making money when we churn people's money, buying and selling, and that's how a lot of brokers make money, is by churning your money in the stock market. They said, well, there's a certain faction of people, especially retirees, they would like to earn more stable rates of return. And E.F. Hutton looked at the multi-trillion dollar insurance industry, and they actually owned a life insurance company themselves. And they said, you know what? This multi-trillion dollar insurance industry is not only the backbone of America, but the backbone of the world. This is where governments go to for help when they need money. This is where banks and credit unions borrow the public's money. When you have your money in a bank or credit union, it's in a lended position. Did you understand that? They're using OPM, other people's money. So you deposit your money in the bank. They borrowed it from you. They pay you right now a measly 1% or less. They turn around and put it in insurance companies and earn 5% or more. That's five times. They make $50,000 on every million they put into insurance companies, and they increase the safety many times by six notches. Most insurance companies where I put my money are rated AAA. Most banks are only rated BBB. AAA is six notches higher in safety. So banks are increasing the safety of the money when they take your money and put it in insurance companies, and the rate of return by 500%. They make 50 grand on every million, not just 10,000 that they pay you. That's a pretty good deal for them, right? Well, you can bypass the middleman with your serious cash for long-term goals. And that's why I would recommend a maximum funded universal life insurance policy, which is the brainchild of E.F. Hutton. So back in 1980, Hutton said, hey, these companies are safer, smarter, they're good money managers. Why don't we put money in them? And that was a high interest environment. And many insurance companies on their general account portfolio where they invest their money, and they invest billions and trillions in AAA and AA bonds and mortgages on skyscrapers and shopping malls and what have you. And they were earning 11 to 15%. So they would keep about one of those percentage points for themselves and pay me the net. So if I earned 11, I net 10. If I earned 15, I would net 14. So let's just use 11 netting 10, because I never earned less than 11.75% from 1980 to 1990. And when E.F. Hutton came up with the idea, it wasn't whole life insurance. Whole life is okay. In fact, they had to become more competitive after the emergence of universal life. But whole life was designed for death benefit primarily. Universal life was designed for living benefits, for tax-free accumulation. Hutton realized there are three sections of the Internal Revenue Code that allow you to accumulate your money tax-free, access your money tax-free, and when you die, it blossoms and transfer tax-free. And that's in a life insurance policy. They would take the amount of insurance they wanted and pay the least premium because they wanted the cheapest policy they could have to cover them when they die. Hutton said, let's flip it. Let's put in the most money the IRS allows, take the least amount of insurance the IRS will let us get away with, and turn it into a tax-free cash cow. Why did they do that? In 1986, which was the second term of Ronald Reagan's presidency, he passed the 1986 Tax Reform Act. And ever since then, Americans only pay income tax on three types of income: earned, passive, or portfolio income. This is salaries, wages. This might be rent or lease income. This is interest or dividends. Now, if you have income that is not one of these three types of income, there is nowhere on a 1040 tax return to put it. It's that cut and dry. And Hutton said, when you take money out of an insurance policy, the smart way, it's not deemed earned, passive, or portfolio income. The IRS knows you're receiving it. They know everything. But it's tax-free, okay? And so it's been a sacred tax-free cash cow for over a century, because insurance is really where you take ownership. You're taking pressure off of the government to provide for widows, orphans, or for your retirement if you live. And so they want to give you a tax incentive. Why would they penalize people who are trying to take pressure off of the government to provide welfare or Social Security benefits? Is this making sense? The sections of the code that E.F. Hutton talked about were Section 101A. This is where money in an insurance policy, when it blossoms and pays out when you die, that's income tax free. But when you're alive, all of the interest, the dividends, the growth is tax free under Section 72E. Under Section 7702, this allows you to access your money while you're alive without paying tax. And so every $1 million that you accumulate can generate 70, 80, 100,000 a year of tax free income if that's what you're earning, and you don't have to report it on your 1040 tax return because it's not earned, passive, or portfolio income. The IRS will know you're receiving it. The insurance company notifies them, but the insurance company says, this is under these sections of the code, it's tax-free. It's not even worth auditing, okay? I've been doing this for 47 years. I'm shooting straight with you here. This is not a tax loophole. This all came out in 1980. And so what happened in a nutshell, I'll explain next. But before I do, if this is intriguing you, be sure and click like, share it with somebody, post a comment, but subscribe to this channel. I have over 500 educational videos to help you understand concepts like this, and I post at least five new ones every single week. Click the little bell so you'll be notified when I do. And at the end of this episode, I'm going to gift you a copy of my most recent 300-page best-selling book called The Laser Fund. how to diversify and create the foundation for a tax-free retirement. In a nutshell, what happened is E.F. Hutton back in 1980 started this, and the IRS got suspicious. Whoa, what are you doing? And so they took E.F. Hutton to court. E.F. Hutton wasn't doing anything wrong. They won. And so the IRS went to Congress, and under a Tax Equity Fiscal Responsibility Act, they expelled the acronym TEFRA. In 1982, they said, well, you've got to have a commensurate amount of life insurance death benefit coming along for the ride. You can't have a dinky amount of life insurance and put in $500,000 or $1,000,000. That's an investment. That's not a tax-free insurance policy. So in order to stay tax-free under these sections of the code, instead of moving over to the investment taxed sooner or later part of the Internal Revenue Code, you had to comply with this. And they decided that you had to have a commensurate amount of insurance. Now, they didn't know what they were doing. How surprising is that? So 2 years later, under the Deficit Reduction Act, that spells the acronym DEFRA, you had to comply with what is called the TEFRA-DEFRA corridor. In a nutshell, it means that you have to have a certain amount of insurance attached to the account so it qualifies as tax-free insurance under these sections of the code. But the older you are, the less insurance that's required, which means it gave parity. What it really means is this. It doesn't matter if you're a 22-year-old athletic marathon-running female, or a 60-year-old, or an 82-year-old friend of our family who had 3 blocked arteries, adult onset diabetes, a prostate cancer episode, 6 sisters predeceased him, and 3 brothers. The cost of the insurance is the same for all of those people. Because the older you are, the less insurance that is required under TEFRA and DEFRA. So the 20-year-old, the 60-year-old, and the 82-year-old can earn 11 and net 10. The cost of the insurance is the same no matter how old you are, because the amount of insurance required is less as you get older. You wouldn't believe how many insurance agents don't understand what I just said. That's why it's so important to go to an IUL specialist to understand this. And I use Indexed Universal Life. Now, TAMRA, the Technical and Miscellaneous Revenue Act, it came out in 1988. And that basically said you can't put in all your money at once. I had many clients put in $500,000 in one fell swoop from 1980 to 1988. After 88, they could still do it. It would grow tax-free, but if they started taking income, it would be taxable. LIFO, last in, first out. In order to be tax-free, they had to slow the flow. They could only put in 1/5 a year, okay? 20% a year, 100 grand a year for 4 years, and one day they could put in the last payment in 4 years and one day if they started funding it the first day of the first year. That's TAMRA. Let's just simplify it. It's like a bucket. You're designing a bucket, a universal life policy, the way E.F. Hutton designed, and you're wanting to put in a certain amount of money, let's say $500,000. Now, there's nothing magic about that. You can put in $100,000 or you can put in $1 million, $10 million. But you're trying to put this in and you want all the interest on this to be totally tax-free. There's a spigot on the bucket, the cost of the insurance that the IRS says has to be there, or it will not be tax-free under those sections of the code. But it's actually watering a money tree that at the end of the day, if I put in $500,000 and I died the next day, it would blossom to $1,250,000. I could buy way more life insurance than that, but that's not the objective. But whatever is in the bucket when I die will blossom and transfer tax-free because of that. That's not a cost, it's a benefit. But it's money that would otherwise go out the window in unnecessary tax. I'd have to be earning 15% to net 10. I only have to earn 11 in net 10 in universal life. And E.F. Hutton is the one who thought about this. They were a brokerage firm. TEFRA, DEFRA, and TAMRA says, okay, you have to have a commensurate amount of insurance. A 60-year-old who wants to put in $500,000 has to have $1,250,000 of insurance. But as that $500,000 doubles to $1 million, the net amount at risk is only $250,000. When that $1 million doubles to $2 million, it exceeds the death benefit. Now you're self-insured. The insurance company's not charging you for insurance anymore. That is the magic, and TAMRA says, well, you have to take only 4 years, one day, $100,000 a year to fill up the bucket. And now, as of December 27th of 2020, you can fill up the bucket in as little as 3 years. They changed it for the first time since 1988. What does this mean? It eliminates the dangers of retirees running out of money because of rising taxes. You link your returns to the things that inflate because Indexed Universal Life outpaces inflation because you're linking your returns to the things that inflate. And you get to participate when the market goes up but not lose when it goes down. Watch my other episodes to understand how you eliminate those dangers. But here's the final message. I call max funded indexed universal life a laser fund, a financial Swiss Army knife. Just like an army knife, I think it is the dream solution, not just for retirement. It's used a lot by Americans for retirement, but the death benefit, retirement planning, but college savings and funding. This knocks the socks off of a 529 plan. Has all the benefits of a 529 and a whole bunch more. You don't have to use the money for college funding. 529, if you don't use it for college funding for your kids, it turns into a taxable account. Working capital for business, okay? Real estate management. You can use it as an emergency fund. Lump sum capital transfer or settlements that you get from an accident or anything like that. Estate planning and pension maximization. If you're a school teacher, take the no survivor benefit and take the difference in the income from being a school teacher, put it into one of these, and it will have all kinds of flexibility that the state's pension does not give you when you select a survivor benefit. If you do that, that's the most expensive insurance policy you will ever buy, is when you select a survivor benefit when you retire from somebody who gives you a defined benefit pension. Well, folks, if this is intriguing you and you want to reduce your taxes, consider a laser fund. So I would recommend you claim a free copy of this book. You simply go to laserfund.com, click on the link below, contribute a nominal amount towards the shipping and handling. I'll cover the rest of that cost. You can get a free copy sent out to you. There's options there to listen and learn with the audio version. Watch and learn. There's even an 18-hour masterclass if you like to watch and learn as I and my two sons teach you about how to diversify and create the foundation for a tax-free retirement. So here's to your brighter future.